Hello friends, now in this lecture we'll continue with the examples. So very next question that I'm going to take from page 681, question number 4. Okay, question is ABCD is a parallelogram. ABCD is a parallelogram. A circle through A, a circle through A, a circle through A, comma B is so drawn that it intersects, that it intersects AD at P and BC at Q. Prove that PQCD are concyclic. Prove that P, D, C and Q are concyclic. Okay, so ABCD is a parallelogram. A circle is passing through A and B. So, but obvious, first I should draw the parallelogram and then I have to draw a circle that should pass through A and B. But it is little bit difficult. So, what I do, I will draw first a parallelogram. Sorry, I will draw first a circle and then I will draw a parallelogram. So, there is a circle in this way. Okay, now parallelogram is such that A and B is on the circle. Point A and point B are on the circle. Suppose this is parallelogram ABCD. Now it is given the circle is drawn such that it intersects AD. So definitely ABCD, so this will be D. AD, that's, this is P and BC. Okay. And BC. Okay. ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay. I hope it is okay. ABCD is a parallelogram, or I can draw a little bit in this way as well. In this way, ABCD is a parallelogram and this point is P and this point is Q, BC at Q. So, we have to prove that P, D, C, Q is a cyclic quadrilateral, or in other words, I have to show that these four points are concyclic. So, a small construction, I will join PQ. Now, anyhow, I have to prove that if I say this has angle 1, so 1 plus 2 equal to 180. Okay, so okay, so let us say this is angle 1. Now my target is to prove either 1 plus D equal to 180 or C plus 2 equal to 180. So definitely I can write angle B plus angle C is equal to 180. Okay, because these are the adjacent angles of a parallelogram, so B plus C equal to 180 degree. Now at the place of C, I can write angle A. Okay, angle A, because opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal. So at the place of C, I wrote A, or simply I can write A plus B equal to 180 degree. So it is almost done. Okay, it's better to start from this only. B plus A equal to 180 degree. At the place of B, I can write D. At the place of A, I can write angle 1. Hence proved. That's it. Okay. A plus B 180 degree. Why? Co-interior angles or the adjacent angles of a parallelogram are supplementary. Now, at the place of B, I kept T because B and D are opposite angles of parallelogram. at the place of A I kept 1 because angle 1 is an exterior angle for cyclic quadrilateral ABQP. Okay, so 1 plus D 180 degree shows that QCDP are concyclic. So let us see how to write this. So given what we have given, ABCD is a parallelogram. ABCD is a parallelogram. A circle drawn through A and B meets AD at P and BC at Q and BC at Q. Okay, to prove what we have to prove, PDCQ and Q are concyclic. That I have to prove. Okay, now let us see its proof. A small construction is required. Okay, what I have to do? Join PQ. Now we will see its proof. It's not that much difficult. First of all, I can write angle A plus B equal to 180 degree. Angle A plus angle B is equal to 180 degree. Reason, I can write co-interior angles, or simply I can write adjacent angles of a parallelogram are supplementary. Therefore, at the place of A, I am writing angle 1 plus B is equal to 180 degree. Okay. Although I can put B equal to here only, but I am taking one extra step. I do write Y angle A equal to 1. Okay, angle 1 is equal to angle A. Reason, exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral is equal to its opposite interior angle. Okay, therefore angle 1 plus angle D is equal to 180 degree. Now here I kept B equal to D. Why? Because B and D are the opposite angles of a parallelogram. B equal to D, reason, opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal. Okay, now 1 and D, therefore I can write P or quadrilateral, therefore quadrilateral PDCQ, quadrilateral PDCQ is a cyclic quadrilateral. Therefore P, D, C and Q are concyclic, hence proved. Okay, why? See, if the sum of opposite angles of a quadrilateral is 180 degree, it's a cyclic. So here I have to write that reason. If the opposite angles of a quadrilateral are supplementary, then quadrilateral is cyclic quadrilateral. So see, actually you have to write the reason in each and every step. That's why it took time, otherwise it was very easy to write the solution. So please note it down, then we will see the next question. ओके नाउ नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन विल सी फ्रॉम पेज नंबर 685. Next question from page number 685, question number 12. AB and AC are AB and AC are two chords of a circle are two chords of a circle of radius R of radius r such that ab equal to twice ac such that ab is equal to twice ac if p and q are the distances of AB and AC from the center of the circle, prove that 4q square is equal to 3p square plus r square. 4q square is equal to p square plus 3r square. AB and AC are two chords of a circle such that AB is equal to twice of AC. So let us see how to solve this. So but obvious, first of all we have to draw a circle having these two chords AB and AC. Okay, and here it is given that AB is twice of AC. So first I am drawing AB. This I took AB. Okay, and this should be twice of AC in this way. Okay, it should be almost double of that as per the diagram. Okay, now that's distance of these two chords from center are P and Q. That means distance of AB from the center is P. This is P. If I draw a perpendicular, let the point is Q and let this point is Z, then OQ is equal to P and OZ is equal to small q. Okay, if P and Q are the distances of AB, so that means P is the distance of AB from O, and Q is the distance of AC from O. Now we have to establish a relation between this P, Q, and if I join this O, then this will become R. Okay, so let us see what we have given. Given in circle O comma R, in circle O comma R, AB and AC are two chords. Okay, further it is given AB is equal to twice of AC. Okay, then OQ perpendicular AB, OZ perpendicular AC. Okay, although I can write OQ is equal to P and OZ is equal to Q. AO is equal to R. Okay, what we have to prove? To prove 4Q square is equal to p square plus 3r square. ओके कंस्ट्रक्शन जॉइन एओ. नाउ वी विल सी इट्स प्रूफ. सो सिंपली यू हैव टू establish a relation between these two. So first of all, I can find the length AB or I can find the length AC in terms of R and Q, and then I will put that value of AB and AC over here. So here this is perpendicular, this also perpendicular. So first of all, I can write that perpendicular from the center to the chord bisects the chord, therefore AQ is equal to half of AB. So perpendicular from the center to the chord bisects the chord. Therefore, I can write AQ is equal to AB upon 2, or I can write AB is equal to twice AQ. Okay, AQ is equal to AB upon 2, and AZ is equal to AC by 2. Okay, now I will apply the Pythagoras theorem in this triangle. I will obtain the value of AQ, and then I will apply the Pythagoras theorem over here and I find the value of AZ, and then I will put those values. So here I can simplify it further. Okay, now we have AB is equal to before I apply the Pythagoras theorem. Okay, let it be first. Now, in triangle AQO by Pythagoras theorem, I can say OQ square plus OQ square. Okay, here it should be AO square. AO square is equal to this. At the place of AO, I can put R. Therefore, R square is equal to AQ square plus, at the place of OQ, I can put P. Therefore, I can write AQ square is equal to R square minus P square. Let it be second. Now, in the same way, I'll apply the Pythagoras theorem in another triangle. Okay, now in triangle AZO, by Pythagoras theorem, AO square is equal to AZ square plus OZ square. Okay, here one thing more can be done. See, I got the value of AQ square, or AQ equal to AB by 2, because ultimately we have to put the value in this. So better to obtain that value over here only. At the place of AQ, I can put AB by 2 is equal to R square minus P square. Okay, so this gives me, okay, before I proceed, let me obtain the value of AB square. Therefore, I can write AB square by 4 is equal to R square minus P square. And hence, I can write AB square is equal to 4 R square minus P square. Okay, let this is be equation number 2. Now, in triangle AZO again by Pythagoras theorem, I can write AO square is equal to AZ square plus OZ square. Now at the place of AO I can write R, at the place of AZ I keep it AZ as it is, and at the place of OZ I can put Q. So this gives me AZ square is equal to R square minus Q square. Okay, now AZ can be written as AC by 2. AC by 2 whole square is equal to R square minus Q square. Therefore, I can write AC square is equal to 4 R square minus Q square. Let it be equation number 3. Okay, I hope it is clear up to this point. First, I obtain this relation. I use those relation over here. Now I will come to the main relation, that is between AB and AC. Now AB is equal to twice of AC. Therefore, AB square is equal to 4 AC square. Now simply what I have to do, I put AB square is equal to this over here and AC square is equal to this over here, and definitely I will get the required result. But before I proceed, note it down up to this point. And here I am writing one thing more. AQ is equal to AB by 2 from first. Okay, similarly over here AZ is equal to AC by 2 from first. Okay, AB equal to twice AC, that is given. Now simply I will put those values. So note it down up to this point. We will see the remaining solution. Okay, so let us see how to solve it further. Okay, at the place of AB square, I'll put 4, therefore 4 R square minus P square is equal to 4. Now at the place of AC square I do put 4 R square minus P square. So this 4 and this 4 cancel out. Therefore R square minus P square is equal to 4 R square minus 4 P square. Sorry, 4 Q square. This is Q square. Okay, 4 Q square. So I'll take 4 Q square over here. 4r square, then this r square over here plus p square. So finally I got my answer, 4q square is equal to 3r square plus p square, hence proof. Okay, so noted down this remaining portion and then we'll see the next question. Okay, after this now we'll start questions from the miscellaneous exercise. Okay, now in miscellaneous exercise maximum questions repeated, there are some questions which are new. Maximum solution of maximum question is given in your book or we had already solved. So over here we'll discuss only those questions which are new. So let us start with miscellaneous exercise. Very first question that I am going to take from miscellaneous exercise is question number 10th. Question number 10th. Miscellaneous exercise, page number 692, question number 10th. Prove that the perpendicular bisectors, prove that the perpendicular bisectors of the sides of the sides of a cyclic quadrilateral of a cyclic quadrilateral are concurrent. Okay, we have to prove that if we draw the perpendicular bisectors of the sides of a cyclic quadrilateral, then they are concurrent. Okay, let us see how to prove this. So first of all, definitely we'll draw a circle. Okay, so we have a circle ABCD, sorry, we have a circle with center O and radius R, and we have also a quadrilateral ABCD. Okay, we have a quadrilateral ABCD as well. So what we have given given a circle O comma R and a and ABCD is a given a circle O comma R and ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral, and quadrilateral ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, that is given. Now what we have to prove to prove perpendicular bisectors, to prove perpendicular bisectors of AB, BC, CD and DA are concurrent. That we have to prove. So let us see how to prove this. Okay, construction is required. See, suppose this is the center of the circle. Okay, now from this center I am drawing a perpendicular on all four sides. Of the quadrilateral ABCD. Let the perpendiculars are OZ, OQ, OS and ON. Okay, I drawn perpendicular OS, ON, OZ and OQ. Now what I have to prove, see actually I have to prove if I draw the perpendicular bisectors of these four sides, they should meet at one point. So what I did in reverse, I drawn the perpendicular. Now, and I also drawn the perpendicular from the same point. Okay. Now, in order to prove that these perpendiculars are the perpendicular bisectors of the side, see they are passing through O. Okay. That thing that I had to prove, I assume that there are perpendiculars which are passing from the same point. Now, in order to prove that perpendicular bisectors are concurrent, it is sufficient to prove that these are the bisectors as well. I just drawn the perpendicular, now I need to prove that these perpendiculars are the bisectors of these corresponding sides, then definitely I can say that perpendicular bisectors of the sides of a cyclic quadrilateral are concurrent. So in construction I do write OQ perpendicular AB, OZ perpendicular BC, ON perpendicular CD and ON perpendicular OS perpendicular AD. OS perpendicular AD. Okay, now we will see its proof. In order to prove that perpendicular bisectors, bisectors of sides of a cyclic quadrilateral are concurrent it is sufficient to prove that S, N, Z and Q or Q, Z and S are the midpoints of AB, BC, CD and D. It is sufficient to prove that Q, Z, N and S are midpoints, or in other words I can say it is sufficient to prove that OQ, OZ, ON and OS and OS bisectors of आर बाइसेक्टर्स ऑफ ए बी बी सी सी डी एंड डी ए रिस्पेक्टिवली. ओके, सो इन ऑर्डर टू प्रूव दैट ओ एस इज अ परपेंडिकुलर बाइसेक्टर, परपेंडिकुलर वी हैड ड्रॉन, नाउ वी हैव टू प्रूव इट इज बाइसेक्टर. सो नाउ फॉर दिस join not actually required, no need to join. Okay, so now we'll use a concept that perpendicular from the center to the chord bisect the chord. Now perpendicular from the center, perpendicular from the center to the chord, to the chord bisects the chord. Therefore I can say perpendicular from the center to the chord bisect the chord. So OQ perpendicular AB, therefore I can say OQ bisects AB. OZ perpendicular BC, therefore OZ bisects CB. ON perpendicular CD, therefore ON bisects CD. And OS perpendicular AD, therefore OS bisects AD. So from these four statement, okay, thus I can say these four are the bisectors of these four respectively. Hence we can say that perpendicular bisectors of sides of a cyclic quadrilateral are concurrent. Okay, thus I can write perpendicular bisectors of sides of a cyclic quadrilateral are concurrent. Hence proof. So please note it down, then we will see the next question. after this, next we will see question number, that was question number 10th. Now we'll see question number 11th. Okay, now question number 11 from the same page number, same exercise. Question number 11 says, in the figure AB equal to CB. In the figure AB is equal to CB and O is the center of the circle and O is the center of the circle and O is the center of the circle. Prove that BO bisects, prove that BO bisects angle BAC. Okay, not BAC, it is angle ABC. Okay, diagram is given, so let us see, a circle is given with center O. Okay, circle is given. Okay, this is center O, the center of the circle. And it is given AB equal to BA equal to BC. Okay, BA is equal to BC, that is given. And O is the center of the circle. We have to prove that BO is the bisector of angle ABC. So we have given in the figure, BA is equal to BC, O is the center of the circle. Okay, what we have to prove, BO bisects angle ABC. That is, we have to prove angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Actually, we have to prove angle 1 equal to angle 2. And it is given BA equal to BC. So, it is not that much difficult. A small construction is required. Construction. Draw perpendiculars from the center to the chord. Okay. Draw OQ perpendicular, draw OZ perpendicular AB, draw OZ perpendicular AB, okay, draw perpendicular OZ from to AB. That is, I can say angle BZO. That is, angle BZO is equal to 90 degree. And draw OQ perpendicular BC. OQ perpendicular BC. That is, angle BQC or sorry, angle BQO. Angle BQO is equal to 90 degree. Now let us see its proof. Okay, so now we have to prove angle 1 equal to 2. So I hope you got the concept. Simply we have to prove these two triangles are congruent, then definitely we can say angle 1 equal to angle 2. Now there are more than one ways to prove this. see these two angles are 90 degree. So very first thing that I can use this angle 90 degree and this is common side, right angle hypotenuse. Now we need one thing more. For that I can use BZ at BQ are equal, because AB and AC are equal, as to these two chords are equal and these are the perpendiculars. So Z will be the midpoint of AB and Q will be the midpoint of BC. By the theorem, perpendicular from the center to the chord bisects the chord. So that gives you that BZ is equal to half of AB. Similarly, BQ is equal to half of BC. Now AB and BC are equal, so their halves will be equal. So this is the one way. Another way, as these two chords are equal and we know that chords are equal are equidistant from the center, so that gives you OZ equal to OQ directly. So it will take less time, so I will go with this. Okay, so AB equal to BC, that is given. Okay, AB equal to BC given. Therefore, I can write OZ. Therefore, OZ is equal to OQ. OZ is equal to OQ. Reason, equal chords are at equal distance. Equal chords are equidistant. Equal chords are equidistant from the center. Okay, this is the first one. Now in triangle, in triangle BZO and triangle BQO, angle BZO is equal to angle BQO, each 90 degree by construction. Okay, then this is the right angle. Now hypotenuse, that is BO. BO is equal to BO, that is common, right angle hypotenuse. Now side, so OZ equal to OQ. OZ is equal to OQ. That from first. Therefore, triangle ZO is congruent to triangle BQO by right angle hypotenuse side. As soon as we say triangles are congruent, I can say angle 1 is equal to angle, hence proof PCP. As the triangles are congruent, their corresponding parts will be equal. So please note it down, then we will see the next question. After this, now we'll see question number 12. See, this is the question that we have solved, discussed so many times. This question was in triangles, then this question again came in quadrilaterals, then in parallelograms and triangles, and here in circles. So here we'll use something, some different method to solve this. Question is, prove that the line segment joining the midpoint of the hypotenuse joining the midpoint of the hypotenuse midpoint of the hypotenuse of a right triangle to its opposite vertex is half of the hypotenuse okay. So let us see how to prove. So it is what we have to prove, that line segment joining the midpoint of a hypotenuse of a right triangle. That means if this is a right angle triangle, then what we have to prove, that midpoint of the hypotenuse which joins the opposite vertex. This, suppose this is triangle ABC and this is point O, so we have to prove this BO is equal to AC by 2. That we have to prove. So first of all, we'll draw a triangle. Okay, that ABC is a triangle, right angle at B. Okay, let O is the midpoint of the hypotenuse. Now, as angle ABC is a right triangle, definitely there is a circle which will pass through these three points ABC, isn't it? This is right triangle and O is the center. That means O will be the center of the circle. Okay, there is a circle which passes through point ABC, making O as the center. Join BO. Now AO, BO and CO are the radii of the circle. So AO equal to BO equal to CO, isn't it? As soon as I say O is the center of the circle, I can say AO equal to CO equal to BO. Now what actually I have to prove, BO is equal to AC by 2. So I can write twice of BO is equal to BO plus BO. Now at the place of BO, I can write AO. Over here I can write CO. So this AC, so here I can write BO is equal to AC by 2. Okay, I started with twice BO is equal to BO plus BO, and this BO I replaced by AO. This BO I replaced by CO. So AO plus CO gives you AC, and this 2 will come over here, so this will become BO equal to AC by 2. So now let us see how to prove this in a way. So definitely what is given to us is a circle, is a triangle with one angle 90 degree. So what we have given, okay, I'm writing a little bit below so that if I need to draw a circle, I have sufficient space. So given triangle ABC is a right triangle, with angle ABC is equal to 90 degree. Okay, that is given. Now what we have to prove, that midpoint of, so I can also say in given O is midpoint of AC. O is midpoint of AC. That is given. Okay. What we have to prove, BO is half of AC. To prove, BO is equal to half of AC. Okay. To prove, बी ओ इज इक्वल टू ए सी बाय टू. ओके सो लेट अस सी इट्स प्रूफ. एंगल ए बी सी, एंगल ए बी सी इज इक्वल टू 90 डिग्री. देयरफोर अ सर्कल सर्कल विल पास थ्रू थ्रू पॉइंट्स ए बी एंड सी. सर्कल विल पास थ्रू पॉइंट ए बी एंड सी. दिस विल बी द सर्कल विच विल पास थ्रू पॉइंट ए बी एंड सी. ओके दिस इज द सर्कल विच डेफिनेटली इज पासिंग थ्रू पॉइंट ए बी एंड सी. ओके ए बी सी इज इक्वल टू 90 डिग्री. सो देर इज देयरफॉर अ सर्कल विल पास थ्रू पॉइंट ए बी एंड सी विथ सेंटर ओ. विथ सेंटर therefore AO is equal to BO is equal to CO is equal to R. okay therefore AO is equal to BO is equal to CO is equal to R. now twice of BO is equal to BO plus BO. therefore twice of BO is equal to AO plus CO. therefore twice of BO is equal to AC and therefore BO is equal to AC by 2. hence proof. okay over here you can write one reason. BO is equal to AO is equal to CO from first. Okay, so please note it down, then we will see the next question. Okay, here you can write that is given. Okay, that is given. As ABC is 90 degree, but obvious AC will be the diameter. Now we will see question number 14. Question number 14. Page number 692. ओके मिसलिनियस एक्सरसाइज. क्वेश्चन नंबर 14 सेज इन फिगर ओ इज द सेंटर ऑफ द सर्कल. इन द फिगर ओ इज द सेंटर ऑफ द सर्कल. ओ इज द सेंटर ऑफ द सर्कल एंड ओ एल एम इज परपेंडिकुलर एंड ओ एल एम इज परपेंडिकुलर टू ए ओ बी. इस पर प्रूव दैट ओके टू थिंग्स वी हैव टू प्रूव प्रूव दैट द फर्स्ट वन इज ए ओ पी एम आर कॉनसाइक्लिक एंड सेकेंड एंगल ओ ए पी ओ ए पी एंड ओ एम बी. ओके दीज टू थिंग्स वी हैव टू प्रूव. इट इज गिवन ओके डायग्राम इज गिवन. लेट अस ड्रॉ द डायग्राम फर्स्ट. The diameter L is the center, so AB is going to be the diameter. Okay, then this is point P. Okay, this point is L. Okay. A, this point, not this point is L. This point is L. This is O. Okay, now you have to prove this point P. M. Okay, so first we have to prove that OLM. O. Sorry, we have to prove A. O P M A O P and M. These four points are concyclic. O P M. That means if I join this, okay, if I join this, then this will be a cyclic quadrilateral that I have to prove. So let us see first of all what we have given. The figure O is the center of the circle. Okay, right now I'm not joining this. Given in circle O comma R, OLM, OLM, or simply I can say OM, OM perpendicular to AB, OM perpendicular to AB. Okay, to prove. What I have to prove, the first thing that I have to prove, AOPM, AOPM are concyclic. And second, I have to prove angle OAP. OAP is equal to OMB. Angle OAP is equal to angle OMB. That two things I have to prove. Actually, only first thing I have to prove. Second is obvious. If these four points are in a circle, then definitely second thing we can write directly. Okay, so let us see how to solve this. See, we had a theorem that if a line segment joining two points, if a line segment joining two points subtend equal angle at two other points, then four points are cyclic. Okay, we'll use that concept over here. See, this AM, if I join AM, then I can say, see, this AM subtend this angle 90 degree because it is given OM perpendicular AB, that means this angle is 90 degree. Now AB is a diameter, so this angle is going to be 90 degree. So as this will be 90, this will also 90. Angle APM is also 90. Now I can say this segment joining A and M subtends equal angles at two other points O and P. So definitely MAOP are cyclic. That is the only thing that we need to prove. So a small construction is required. Join AM. Okay, now we'll see its proof for that. Okay, first of all, it is given OM perpendicular AB given. Therefore, I can say angle AOM is equal to 90 degree first. Okay, now AB is a diameter. Therefore, angle APB is equal to 90 degree. As angle APB 90 degree, I can write, therefore angle AP, okay, or if you want to apply the linear pair, with that I can do. Now, angle APB plus angle APM plus angle APM is equal to 180 degree. By linear pair axiom, therefore 90 plus angle APM is equal to 180 degree, and hence I can say angle APM is equal to 90 degree. Let it be equation number 2. Okay, now from first and second I can say angle AOM is equal to angle APM 90 degree. Let it be third. Okay, now it is almost done. Now we proved these two angles are equal. Now we'll apply that theorem. So now we do write actually that theorem. Now a line segment joining, now if a line segment If a line segment joining two points, if a line segment joining two points here A and M, if a line segment joining two points subtends equal angles at two other points here, those two points are O and P, here O and P, okay, and I can also write and AOM is equal to APM from second, okay, from second, okay, if a line segment joining two points, those two points are A and M, subtends equal angle at two other points, here points are O and P, and these are the angles that we proved already, subtends equal angle, then those four points are concyclic. Those four points are concyclic. Therefore, I can write AO, therefore AOP and M are concyclic. Okay. Hence proved first. Okay, hence proved first. Here I am changing their number. Hence proved first. Okay, now as AOPM are concyclic, definitely these two angles are going to be equal. OMP and OAP. Why? Because they are in the same segment OP. Okay, therefore I can write angle, therefore write angle OAP, therefore angle OAP is equal to angle OMP, angle OMP. Reason, angles in the same segment, angles in the same segment are equal. Angles in the same segment are equal. Therefore, okay, see what we have to prove, AP is as it is, but at the place of OMP, OMP, I can write angle OMB. Therefore, angle OAP is equal to angle OMB. Hence, proved second. Okay, so I hope this is clear to you. Please note it down. Okay, now we will see question number 21. That is from page number 693. Okay. Question says, if in the given figure, question is, in the given figure, O is the center of the circle. O is the center of the circle. And PO bisects angle, and PO bisects angle APD. Prove that AB equal to CD. Prove that AB is equal to CD. Okay, so first of all, let us draw a circle. Now in this circle there are two chords AB and CD, they are intersecting at point P. AB and CD. This way. Okay, these are the two chords and this is the point A. This is the center of the circle and this OP is the bisector of angle APD. That means it is given angle 1 is equal to angle 2. So we have to prove these two chords will be equal, AB and CD. So let us see how to prove given in circle O comma R chords AB and CD meet at point P. Okay, OP bisects angle APD. That is angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Okay. What we have to prove, AB is equal to CD. To prove AB equal to CD. Okay, a small construction is required. So think about what construction is needed. Also think how you will proceed, then I will give you its solution. Okay, so let us see. See, we have to prove AB equal to CD. So what we'll do, we draw a perpendicular on AB and on CD. Okay, So we have to draw a perpendicular OQ and OZ on AB and CD. So construction, draw OQ perpendicular AB, that is angle OQP, angle OQP is equal to 90 degree. Also draw OZ perpendicular CD, that is angle OZP, angle OZP is equal to 90 degree. Now we have to prove AB equal to CD. So we know there is a theorem that perpendicular, if the chords are equidistant from the center, they are equal in length. That means if I say the length OQ is equal to length OZ, definitely I can say AB is equal to CD. So for that I need to prove OQ equal to OZ. For that I need to prove these two triangles congruent. So in triangle POQ, in triangle POQ and triangle POZ, angle 1 is equal to angle 2, that is given, it is given that OP is bisector of angle APD. Then angle OQP is equal to angle OZP, angle OZP, that is again I can say by construction, it is not given but by construction. Okay, now after this OP is common in these two, OP is equal to OP, that is common, and hence I can say these two triangles POQ is congruent to triangle POZ by angle side. Okay, see, still we are in the congruency, still the use of congruency is there. As these two triangles are congruent, I can say OQ is equal to OZ. Okay, by CPCT, this is by CPCT. Now as these two these two lengths are equal, but these two, okay, but OQ and OZ are the distances of chords AB and CD from the center respectively. Okay, these are the perpendicular distances of these two chords from the center. Okay, therefore AB is equal to CD, hence proof. Now here reason is that chords equidistant from the center are equal in length. Chords equidistant from the center are equal in length. Okay, so please note it down. ओके सो दैट इज ऑल अबाउट दिस लेक्चर एज वेल एज दिस चैप्टर. नाउ विल मीट इन नेक्स्ट लेक्चर एंड विल नाउ विल मीट इन नेक्स्ट लेक्चर एंड विल स्टार्ट न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज स्टेटिस्टिक्स. टिल देन बाय. थैंक यू. टेक केयर. स्टे एट होम.